Hey guys, it's Dawn, and I am very excited to be participating in Laura's 1,000 YouTube subscribers video hop. There are a lot of participants, and there are prizes along the way, so make sure that you visit all of the videos and leave comments to win prizes. I'll have all the details in my description box. So for my project, I decided to take something that Laura does a lot, which is a background wash, and bring it into the foreground. And then we're going to take that same technique in the same image, and we're going to double it as this framed print that you could also give as a gift with the card. I'm using the Hope Seed Company stamp set by W+9, and this is great because it has these lined images in it, and so it's really good for this wash technique. I'm using the poppy image because it has the largest open area. We'll also be using some distress markers, distress ink, white embossing powder. You'll need your VersaMark, of course, some clean water, and I'm going to be adding a little Perfect Pearls to my watercolor to add a little bit of shimmer. I've got a 4.25 by 5.5 inch watercolor panel here, and I've just gone ahead and rubbed it down with my embossing buddy to remove any static. Now you'll notice in our final piece that this actually is 4 poppy flowers and the stamp only has 2. We're going to build up the image. So what I'm doing here is I want to be able to see where I've stamped. So I'm inking it up first in Tim Holtz Distress Ink and Fine Linen, which is a really, really light color. Now I'm going to add my VersaMark. When I stamp this onto the paper, it's going to create this very light image that I can then see, and I can better judge where to place my second impression. That way I don't accidentally overlap the image and it looks like one continuous line of poppies. For the second impression, I didn't want one of the little leaf segments, so I just masked it off with some tape before stamping. Now you'll notice that I was pressing pretty hard, and that's because we are on watercolor paper and it has a lot of texture to it. And you want to make sure that you get that VersaMark in all of the little nooks and crannies and the grooves, so you get a good clean embossed image. Now I've just sprinkled on my embossing powder and I'm knocking off the excess. Another great thing that you can do is just use your paintbrush to tidy up any areas. If you had some overlapping areas, you didn't quite mask it off right, you can just go ahead and knock that off. Now we're going to have some fun. We're going to use the concept of the background wash, but we're going to apply it to the foreground here, to the focal image. I'm going to start by laying down clean water, and I'm going to let this bleed outside of the petals. I want the color to look like it's bursting out from the petals and creating this abstract look, but with a little bit more control, kind of controlled chaos, the story of my life. To add a little bit of shimmer, I'm going to mix a little bit of Perfect Pearls with some spiced marmalade that I've already laid down on my craft mat. I'm only going to use the shimmer in one color because I just want to add just a little bit. I don't want to go overboard. And I'm going to start dropping this into the wet areas and letting it just bleed around. And I'm actually going to tap inside the petals, I'm going to tap outside of the petals, and I'm just going to let that water that I've laid down on the watercolor paper move the pigment around. Even though we're going for a more abstract final product here, I like to define my flowers first. So here you can see that I've pretty much defined those first 2 flowers, and now I'm going to drop a little bit more of that color onto the outside of the petals. Then I'm going to come in with clean water and spread that out. Now as I add the water and I move it out toward the edge of the paper, it will cleanly, it will gradually fade out into clear water, and it creates this really nice soft haze. I'm going to continue pulling that water down into the other 2 flowers, and then I'll pick up more color and start dropping that into those as well. I'm going to go into fast motion here so you can see how this kind of all comes together, but I'm just going to keep repeating the same techniques, laying down water, laying down color. When the areas are still wet, I can just continue to drop more color into those without adding more water, and it'll intensify those areas. If my paper starts to go dry, I can just pick up some more water and help move that ink around. We're going to repeat the exact same thing with our second color. We're using Fired Brick, so I'm going to lay that down on my craft mat. And if my paper is still wet, then I'm good to go. If not, then I'll need to wet it a little more. But I'm going to work fast here so that everything is still wet, so it bleeds together really nicely. Pick it up and start dropping it in the exact same way that I did with the yellow. And once again, we're going to go into fast motion. Here I'm concentrating the red toward the center where I want the flowers to be darkest. And then again, I'm adding it to the outside of the petals and letting it bleed out. For the center of the flowers, I'm picking up some black soot and I'm adding that toward the very center. And then randomly in some spots here and there, just so it doesn't look too contrived. Again, my paper's really wet, so it's actually allowing it to bleed up into that red and create this nice deep violet color. Everywhere we've got embossing, especially in the center there, it's going to resist it. So we're just going to leave it there and we'll wipe it up after it's dry. Once again, we're going to go into fast motion and I'm just going to continue adding color. I'm going to add some green to the leaves and the little buds here, and then I'm going to allow that to spread out. And I'm going to use several different colors. I'm going to be using peeled paint and crushed olive, and I'm even going to add in some frayed burlap. So the background wash is probably the easiest watercolor technique to learn, and it's a great beginner technique. It's a great way to get yourself acquainted with the water and how it moves the pigment around, and learning how much water you're comfortable with using, how the different amounts of water affect the color. And it's just a lot of fun. And when you apply it to your foreground or your focal image like this, you come out with this little mini masterpiece that is actually really, really easy. And it looks like, oh yeah, I intentionally, did all of this. No, I didn't. The water just did it. I know some of my favorite pieces happened when the water didn't want to cooperate with me, and I almost threw it away, and then I would come back and I'd be like, well, I guess that water knew what it wanted to do. Now, no abstract piece is complete without some splashes of color and some splatters. So for that, I like to use the liner brush. It's this really long bristled brush and actually holds quite a bit more water than it looks. It's a very deceiving brush. It holds quite a lot of pigment. So I'm loading that up with some spice marmalade and some more of that perfect pearls, and then I'm just going to start tapping the back of my hand to splash these random colors all over the place. In some places, my brush is even hitting the cardstock, and I realized that I kind of liked that. It just added a little bit more bold, odd shape, more organic shapes, something that I probably couldn't have done on my own, if not by accident. So I just left them. I didn't even worry about them. And you can go as crazy with this as you want. I was actually feeling a little daring when I did this one and went quite a bit more liberal than I normally do. And I end up, picking up several of the colors that we used in the flowers and just went to town, literally. So now that this is pretty much dry, I can remove the black that has settled on top of my embossing, and then I can just add just a little bit more black to that center. Now that I've removed that, I can see how dark or light that center is, and I've decided that I want it actually a little bit darker. So I'm just going to come in and reinforce that center. And that's pretty much all there is to this technique. It's super simple but very impactful. All you need to do now is add your sentiment and make it a card, or you could do this on a bigger sheet of paper and then you could mat it and frame it, and it makes a great gift. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know I have enjoyed participating in this video hop. Great big congratulations to Laura on your milestone. I am sure you have many more to come, because girl, you are crazy talented. Don't forget to check my description box. There is a link to the next video. Don't forget to leave comments along the way, because we have several sponsors giving up many prizes, including a $25 gift card to wplus9.com. So check the description box, follow the links, and I will catch you guys next time. See ya!